Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Reproduction in Plants. In that, we are studying topic Anemophily. When I say Anemophily, it means pollination with the help of wind or air. Today we'll be studying how wind or air helps in pollination. For pollination, that is to transfer pollen grains from anther to stigma near the female gametophyte, there are various agents to do that. One of those agents is wind or air, and pollination by wind or air is called as anemophily. This type of pollination is seen in various plants, jawar, bajra, wheat, all those plants. Now, imagine if there is air flowing. The chances of pollination are far better as compared to water, birds, animals, since wind is going to go nowhere. For wind pollination, what could be the requirements? How has to be the flower and how has to be the pollen grain? The flower should be colorless. For wind, it doesn't matter the color of the flower. It also should be inconspicuous. The weight of the flower should be light, whereas the pollen grains should be produced in larger quantities. You know that during wind pollination, there are chances that some pollen grains would be lost. Also, they should be in lightweight, since wind can carry lightweight pollen grains faster. The pollen grains has to be produced and should be sticky enough so that they can stick properly in the stigma, or you can say while traveling through the passage of style. If you talk about the fragrance of the flower, for wind pollination, fragrance of the flower doesn't matter. Apart from that, the pollen grains that are produced into various plants has to be produced in larger quantity, since there are a lot of chances of wastage of pollen grains during wind pollination. Apart from that, during wind pollination, various plants, all the wheat variety or majority flowers are pollinated by anemophily process. For anemophily or by pollination by wind, the requirements are that the flower has to be colorless. Obviously, the color of the flower won't affect the wind. Even in conception, small flowers would work. The flower has to be having without fragrance, or a flower with fragrance will even work. There is no need of nectar, since during wind pollination, there is hardly honeybee or an insect or bird involved. Whereas, there are certain qualities that the pollen grain should possess during wind pollination, and those are: the pollen grains should be light. Obviously, the lighter the pollen grain, the far it can travel with the wind. Even they has to be dry and smooth. At the same time, large number of pollen grains should be produced, since there are chances that some amount of pollen grains could be wasted during wind pollination. For wind pollination or anemophily, the stigma, or you can say the female part, has to feathery, or it should be easily able to catch the pollen grain. For this, it has to produce the sugary substance, which helps in interaction of pollen grains with the stigma, or you can see the passage through which the pollen grains travel. Some common example of anemophily pollinated plants, or you can say wind pollinated plants, are coconut plum, date, maize, and sugarcane. Students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied about how anemophily or wind can help in pollination of plants. I hope you all are clear with this concept. Thank you.